Lukey. Starting to get a little tune on it now.
I'd just be doing what the squire showed us.
A sort of tune spooks would take to, I'd say. You reckon you'd charm him out, eh?
You heard what it said, Jeff.
I only heard him say you're after spooks.
Squire reckons to stop anybody coming through here in the dark without us knowing.
Ah, spooks would pass straight through a rover, and to know that. Pass the rover to spook, don't even tickle him.
It ain't spooks he's setting them up for, Jeff. It's jokers. There's plenty of them hereabouts.
Oh, ah.
Any tricky lad comes bolting through here tonight will set this lot off, and we'll have him. If it's time to finish, just take it as far as that forfeit kit, and we'll do. Hey, where's young Sam?
There, look. Just went off by himself.
Young devil.
Reckon he's frickened?
Afraid of the squire more like for making it up. Couldn't hear it tonight, that owl. There's no rat squealing there. Makes some folk frickened if you didn't know what it were.
I know them noises. Felt like I heard that all the time.
Alright.
Lukey, I don't want to come back here tonight.
Tell that to the squire. Come on now.
Hey, Lukey. Bring all get a free drink on this.
The squire's promised it.
I'll say this about the squire. He might be soft in the head, but he's open in the hand.
Oh, sorry, Squire.
No matter, no matter.
Oh, beg pardon, Squire. I've just got the logs.
Logs? Surely we need no logs.
He wants them.
Landlord, quick now!
Yes, sir. Where's Jack? Devil take him. Brandy then, quick! I must go for logs.
Making your daily jump, girl. Who's he?
Mr. Cobb.
It's Mr. Cobb, then.
Friend of Squire's.
Well, I can see that, but...
He got off the London coach.
Where is the brandy for my master? Bring it.
Father, I've got the brandy.
Take it in, then.
Hey, me?
Yeah, you.
In jars like this, I've got secure samples of imponderable fluids, which, if I'm right...
Where are them damn logs? Send him in with them! I'm dying of cold! Oh, my dear. I thought it was your villain of a father.
Let's get to the logs, sir.
Good. What's your name?
Patsy, so please you.
Why did you ask him here?
Pretty. Will you join me? Ah, you're wise. At least it washes away the coffee. I doubt they've ever made coffee here before I do.
I must apologise once again, Mr. Cobb, for putting you through all of this.
No, no. The coach was late.
We had everything ready for you at the hall. Timothy had even been to the cellar to choose the wines.
Wines? Not imponderable fluids. I'm honoured. Sir, do you keep a chemical chamber at the hall? A laboratory?
Yes.
You've studied long?
A number of years. Mostly on my own.
Rewarding, eh?
Yes. Indeed.
Most singular. A squire that would sooner hunt a chemical element than a fox.
Shall I go on?
Please.
If tonight there should be manifestations, I would expect changes in the air, the release of imponderable fluids, phlogiston caloric, even the electric fluids. Now, for the electric fluids...
Here you are, sir.
It's intolerable.
Logs.
Tell them all on! I need a great blaze to thaw my vitals. If you dragged for 10 hours behind those damn lame jades.
I feel so guilty.
And then make some more coffee. I don't know how he brews it. I've tasted naught like it in London.
We have our ways, sir.
Aye. Coffee is the element I float in, my dear. Be it exquisite or vile. I chart my way through the flavours like a great whale in the sea. Now, where do we meet in London? I swear it was it Mrs. Brooks?
It was.
There. I never forget a bean. The aroma, nay, the aura of that Mrs. Brooks. But you, Squire, I swear you were not there.
No.
I was up in town alone, visiting my cousin.
No, sir. I think you were not.
Ah, there now. I can soon pick up.
Thank you. So, this witness of yours,
Sam Towler,
and he's with them?
Yes, they've been roping off the area with alarm bells to detect intruders.
You mean hoaxers?
Yes.
You admit it could all be an imposture then?
Keep an open mind, I must. But I think not. I think there's something here worth probing. With all the means we have.
Not forgetting Pussy.
Ah, yes. The cat's head. What does it do?
It may provide additional traction for electrical fluids.
How?
Whiskers.
And ornamental in a way. In a way. Now, sir, I see you've formed your theory already. No! Don't protest. I see you're positively agog with it.
In some sense, I...
A new proof of the existence of hobgoblins?
No, sir. Then confound me, sir.
Imagine. Imagine that hereabouts in the far past... There was some catastrophic event.
Was the one?
So they say.
What?
Queen Boadicea fled through the woods with her army.
Ah, Queen Boadicea.
Wait, wait. An event of such spiritual force that it somehow imprinted itself onto the very landscape. Ale for these fellows. Two full tankers each. No more. I want clear heads tonight. Now, Lukey.
We've finished, Squire. You'd metal enough?
Aye. Our quest was later. I would have come out myself. Tell me, is anything heard or seen?
Proceed.
Sam Towler, my master wishes to speak to you.
Don't go with him. His master ain't yourn. He can't make you.
Come along, please.
Now, now, this is well enough.
Come along, man. Bring your ale.
This is Sam.
Ah. Are you honest, Sam?
I can answer for him. You worked in my stables for... how long?
Since a young man, sir.
So you can carry a hunter's coat, Sam. Wax a saddle and shine brasses. All honest things. But... are you honest in the mind?
What do you mean, sir?
Indeed. Mr. Cobb?
Honest with yourself? Not many achieve it.
Sam, Mr. Cobb has come from London tonight to help us. I think you should tell him your story.
Don't fear me, lad. I'm not a hanging judge or a high constable. I'm a philosopher. Do you know what that is?
Aye, sir. Like the squire.
Not exactly like. I have none of those remarkable chemical jars. I'm obliged simply to think about the truth. Come now. I mock nothing but folly and knavery. Let us be two good fellows, eh? Helping each other towards illumination. Jethro, take notes.
Tetsu, come away.
T'was last year, a couple of days after Michaelmas.
Exactly 1 year ago tonight. First day of October, 1769. And that night, you were out in the woods.
Yes, sir.
Why?
Just wondering about.
Alone?
Yes.
And for how long?
Hours. It was full dark where I heard the noises.
The noises?
Weren't much at first. Smell like whistles and squeaks. I thought it were birds. It weren't birds.
What were they then?
I don't know. They started to burst out more. Very loud. And in between whiles, it was quiet.
And then I was laying on the ground. And I could feel it starting to shake. And the noises coming nearer. A roaring and a rattling like no time ever did hear. I was frickin', sir.
Rattling? Of what? Wheels? Chains?
Neither one, I don't think.
Can you? Can you, I wonder? Can you imitate any of these sounds for us? With your mouth? Thank you. How'd you set that down, Jethro?
A kind of buzz. Or hum.
There seem to be voices, too.
Human voices?
Aye, sir. Yelling and screeching. And footsteps running on the ground I was lying on.
You mean they ran in the earth?
Right under me where I lay. But the queer thing was, they sounded like feet on cobbles.
Footsteps on cobbles.
There's nothing but turf and leaf moulds throughout the woods.
And the voices?
They were all around me. I stopped up my ears like this. Oh, I tried. But it made no matter.
Could you pick out words?
None that I could make sense of.
Latin, perhaps?
But were they in our tongue?
Some might have been.
Tell
me. Mainly, it was all the screams and screechings, near and far away too. Like as if all the dead people were rising out of hell and covering the land.
And then, it must have stopped. I don't recall. The queerest of all, nobody else heard it.
No one?
I couldn't believe that. Couldn't you?
Don't torment him!
There's no harm, girl.
Sir, you must stop them. She was listening. I had to. I couldn't help it.
Get out of here.
No! Wait! Please! Now, sir. I want you to tell me, for whom were you waiting in the woods that night? For her?
Oh, no, sir. It was not then. Or not.
Ah, I beg pardon. Some former sweetheart, then.
Meg.
But she didn't come. Not that night.
Ah. You waited in vain. And there's our picture. An overwrought young man in a lonely place. His fancy hard at work.
And then he made it up.
I didn't, sir.
I'll tell you what you heard, shall I? You heard your own heartbeat. Throbbing against the ground. You heard the small creatures in the undergrowth.
No, sir. No.
But, chief of all, you heard your own memory. Now, I'm told there's an ancient tale about that... that queen of ancient times.
Queen Bodicea?
There! He knows it!
They say she came through these woods with her whole army in rout.
All those sad barbarians, sweating the blue woad off their bodies as they fled.
Tossing their spears away.
Yelling and screaming in their terror. And behind them, the trumpets and the drums. The rolling drums of the Roman army.
It may well have happened.
Happened or not, it's what he learned at his mother's knee. See how the rascal's eyes shine. Oh, Sam. Sam. You'd make a writer. A veritable Grub Street romantic. If only you'd learned your ABC. It's been in his mind since childhood, this Faustian tale. And when he's in an emotional state, well, it comes back to him. And there. There's your phantom army.
That's not what I heard.
But, what's he say?
You tried to show me as a fool, sir. I've thought about this many a day. As honestly as you could wish. But I know. 'Twere that queen and her people who I heard. If they had come by here, they would have had chariots. That's like carts, ain't it? And horses! I've heard drums too. And trumpets. In town, when the soldiers came, 'twas none of these things. None of them. Let me by. I heard men grin on a great cobbled road through the woods. But there's no road there. Nor ever has been.
That's true. It's always been forest land.
Come, sir, come. Do you realise what you're doing? You're adducing this very lack, this nothing, as if it supported his tale. Has no one else ever heard these sounds?
John Mosley. An old poacher. 3 years ago. He was in the woods. That must have been the same night of the year. But that signified naught until young Sam here...
Where is this old man?
He died. About a week later.
Of shock, presumably.
He was took mortal strange.
How disobliging of him! And there's no other witnesses of this remarkable annual uproar. You must all live within a mile or two. Nobody? Yourself, sir? Your lady? Your servant? With one exception.
Out in the woods. We leave in 10 minutes. It'll be a cool night, sir. Very well. Hot toddy for every man before we go. Small ones, though. I take it, sir, he will not be with us.
Oh, he must. Who else will stand for common sense?
Thank you, Adam.
It was for that that I invited Mr. Cole.
And that only.
What do you mean, sir? When Sir Timothy told me he was going to investigate, I thought you might like to come. I need a hand. What did you think of him?
You're rustic. A head full of fright and old wives' tales.
He seemed honest. In the mind.
Did he so? As you can see, he has more than a flunky's training. He has a mind. I've made him use it.
I use it.
Demonstrate it. Show the lady some excellence on this topic.
I have thought. You may not approve of this. It's a matter of scale. Our minds are limited in a limitless universe. There may be forces whose nature we can in no way grasp, inaccessible to our finest philosophy.
Don't quote!
Did I?
More things in heaven and earth, Horatio. Above all, don't quote a poet, a professional liar. You've been taught some discipline of the mind, Jethro. Never, never betray that. I would not have those about me who would open doors to confusion and magic. Get out! Get out there and help them!
Sir, may I take those things out for you? The electroscope.
You know what this is?
Yes, in spite of the cat.
Please, take it.
Taxi! Where are you, girl?
Coming, Father.
Jethro's an experiment. You see, I make them too. On the whole, he works.
He's a man. Why do you not respect him?
Respect? Respect, sir? Respect is no part and parcel of the matter. You might as well have asked me to respect him for the silver buckles I've put upon him.
I can respect him.
You have the vice of politeness about you.
Politeness? A vice?
Nay, in many it is. Should he succeed this night, he'll beg pardon of the ghosts for raising them. Truth in Tori, sir. Well, here's to your enterprise.
There's not even a gibbet round these parts.
I know not about that.
Over to pay last coming, do that. That old gibbet there, place her alive with her. Every night, won't you? Not just once a year.
I have said service must come to an end. Not quite the same thing. Good or bad, it must end by being ridiculous. Machines will supplant it.
Machines?
I have no possible doubts about it. The great steam pumps we see now are going to have 1 million descendants. In 100 years, in 2 certainly, machines will do all the world's fetching and carrying. They'll be more obedient, loyal, industrious than any servants in history. They'll carry men through the air and over the seas.
Mr. Cobb.
They'll sow and reap for us. Water the desert. Melt the polar snows.
All this with steam?
Ah. They'll be greater forces.
The imponderables.
No, sir. Powerful real forces that actually exist. That must exist. To bind this universe and to quicken it. The very sources of life. Man will find them in the end.
Yes, I suppose so. So each of us contributes his...
My poor squire, man will do this by using his mind utterly anew, plumbing the deepest levels of insight and reason. Not by sniffing at those sorcerer's jars. The nose will serve, sir. But not to find a bad smell. 'Tis the brain must do it. Is your carriage here?
Yes, we go to the woods on foot.
The woods? Are we really bound to this buffoonery?
We?
Yes, you and I. When I think of those wines of yours, back in the hall.
Oh, no.
Lying. Untasted.
Your world of machines. I think I should like that. But not yet. I can't. We should go with the others. Perhaps they'll even be philosophical machines.
To do our thinking. Aye. At least they'll not believe in bogies.
Go on, you headless old Orion.
I'll
kill them dead all over again. And they look like vermin to frickin' their friends. How much are we giving for them, Squire? A shilling a head? Eh? What about fellas has got none? A shilling a body.
You ain't quick.
Well, I am then.
What's this about?
She wants to call, sir.
Any hassle can go, I can go. I'm not easily fricking, sir.
Faith, let her come. And remember all what I said. No shouting, no laughing, and keep your ears open. We're like to return no wiser than we are now. But let's be sure. If you do hear anything, come to me at once. Now, two men to light the way.
Have you heard of buzzing from those machines?
That they can free man from his folly. I believe that, yes.
How can they? You'll have made them.
This route.
Right, pull this way. Heave now, lads. Heave! Heave!
Oh, it's so muddy.
Jethro, help the lady. I'll take the lantern.
I didn't see the rope.
Timothy, you're not hurt.
Well, sir, you sprung your own trap.
Yes, well, I... You see how it works. If anyone sets off the, Oh, you saw. Squire just put it into the test light.
No.
Now then, Sam.
Yes, sir?
Can you show us the exact spot?
Yonder, by the fallen tree.
That'll serve, lads. Now, to unload.
Go help there!
It's intact. Thermometer. It says that supernatural events are marked by a great chilling of the air. I'm ready to test that.
Good.
Now, my equipment. Clear it over here, to the clearing. This way, this way.
Are you not to help him?
He's not talking in these matters.
Say either.
Either. Mr. Cobb.
He'll be out after marsh damps, or subjecting copper to the seven heats, when he'd do better in bed. Why did you marry him? Grew up in the country. The vicar's daughter. I knew it. A match for the young squire. Well, younger than some. A baronet.
I've met a score of him. Gentlemen amateurs with a nose for idle novelty. God a mercy. Look at this. Yorick, too. What company of actors had he these from?
They passed in the spring. Playing Julius Caesar.
And he sets the scene.
Show him. What he is. You can.
A bargain. I had a cat once, her name was Tib. And she was a great killer. Yes. There was something about her.
Her eyes?
The corner of her mouth. But Julie! You couldn't catch imponderables in the jar. By their very nature, they will escape through the glass. That's if they exist at all.
There may be something else.
Oh?
Something heavier. Animal magnetic fluid. I should call it that. Something like the magnetic fluid of iron. Excluded instead by living creatures.
Is this your own idea?
Suppose it had the quality of lingering, like some violent action of the past had riven it into the earth, to issue forth again, at certain times and under certain conditions, at times like the yearly cycle, at each anniversary of some great disaster, more especially near the century mark.
Lantern girl!
As if part of the vital spirits of people have been torn away under some dreadful pressure of fear and death.
Part of their souls?
There, my dear. I think the squire means something more. More chemical than souls. Besides, Queen Boadicea was officially doubted to have had any. She was a pagan! Your master's going to insist on the old queen, my lad. She fits his theory. So, if she shows herself tonight, he'll bottle her up.
If anything happens... Oh, leave me be.
But you'll make it happen, sir. Try at least, or... Why all this? Ancient Rome. The centurion and his horse.
It might help to distill out the...
The chaser. Into your bottle. But the text, sir, from Caesar. She was not born in Caesar's day.
Join to the electric stump, no, to a mason jar. Can you do that?
Yes, sir.
I've made trial electrical discharges before, during thunderstorms.
Oh, with kites like Benjamin Franklin.
That's right. Flying forks up into the storm. The wet fluid comes down the line. I got a bad burn once.
Shall we get burns tonight?
I'd be glad to. With so many people here, it may excite the forces. Should these themes, in a sense, focus them? You understand, don't you?
Well, Jeffro, do you?
Let's get the cart away. I want it down there.
Sir, a word. Before this handled attempt goes too far.
By the rope.
And you, a laughingstock of the entire county. Think of your lady. You're a singular fellow, sir. But don't set yourself up to be an eccentric.
Sir,
where did you get all this rubbish from? A bankrupt sorcerer? You don't even know what half of it is.
I make serious observations.
The best of them are so crude you can prove whatever you fancy. That mice are created by sour teas. That sneezing endangers the monarchy.
I am not a fool, sir.
Then throw away the toys.
Have an open mind.
Then close it, sir. Close it to nonsense.
Keep your voice down.
If you want proof, I can tell you how to find it.
Pray do.
You need not seek it with quaint instruments. You have only to open your eyes if you can. And see what is before you.
That's too easy.
It is not easy. It is so hard that only a handful in the land, or any land, have yet achieved it.
They must scour their minds clean, ready for a new usage.
Then turn their whole imagination right round. Away from all the romantic fancies that delight it. And then blur it and deaden it.
And bring that imagination to bear instead on the real world that it has taken for granted. And see into it. And seek its deepest sense.
The truth. The truth is all around us. But it is hard. And ordinary. And extreme.
And you have achieved this, this cleansing of the brain.
No, not wholly. But I shall.
And how many others?
In time a world full. Man will change himself.
I could not.
Then you will be left behind, sir. A mere bone in the rocks like a creature of the great flood. And all like you, the men of the future, will be those who see things as they are.
Go on, Timothy. Argue, refute him.
How can I? He denounced his fantasy only to set up another one.
I get good sense for nonsense. New lamps for old.
Bravo!
Come, sir. Try the exchange. He will not.
Let's leave poor Timothy in his rock and go on. I want to feel history sweeping me away like a great warm tide.
It will be a world of men and women with open eyes. They'll be strong.
They'll need no crutches for petty trammelling morality.
Faith? Is there morality now?
No. But they'll be spared the pretense. They'll see each other as they truly exist. And count each other's needs as they accept them. Even joyfully, but above all, honestly. They may count our virtues vice, and our vices natural wisdom. They'll judge all things afresh by their own enlightenment.
God will judge.
They will judge. They won't go in dread seeking heavenly marks for good behaviour, like tots in dame school. They'll have grown up.
There must be God. And justice.
Justice, sir, is a god. The god of misers. It defines the way we may snatch from each other and then guard our grabbings. You say justice, and you exalt a golden blindfolded lady. I see a gibbet and a thing hanging with its eyes pecked out.
Oh, you're right.
Law is for cowards and blockheads. For today's foul little world, not for theirs. They'll have no faith and cholera and killing for theft. Who will steal in a world where every man's a prince? There'll be neither squire nor servant then.
Nor servant?
Nor servant. They'll have such riches that our great King George would look like a pauper. It's in the earth for the asking. And they'll have learned to ask, that's all. They'll build a world that's clean and ordered and swift. It'll come. It must.
The world of machines.
Aye, great engines that could build you a pavilion of shining metal and keep your beauty perfect for 100 years.
Is this the new realism?
No disease, no cruelty, no want. All that man gains, man will give.
Love, too.
Aye. That too. That most of all.
You're not bound to stay, but for those who do, there'll be food in an hour. You blind us with your golden age, Mr. Cobb. Tell me, have you no doubts?
Phew.
I have doubts. I doubt everything I do.
With reason. You're a fool to go on.
I know that, but I must. I go slowly. I get my knowledge grain by grain as I come upon it. I go without direction, feeling my way. I test the ground. I move aside if it won't bear me. And go on again.
Like a beagle?
No, like a man. The only discovery I've made, Mr. Cobb. Hassel's law. Man can never move back.
Not even the owl now. He's gone to bed. Come on, my dears, show yourselves. There's gentry waiting here for you.
Jeff. And I don't trust him.
Thank you, my dear.
Would you share her?
She's got a man. She's satisfied. For the present.
You were saying just now that immortality is what gives us pain. Then the London wives and their lovers must suffer a great deal.
Not a bit.
But surely...
They're not immoral. They're enjoying a natural virtue. What morality is there being tied to a dotard, for instance?
Or a dullard. I begin to understand.
You've much to learn. You must learn it.
Yes, I must.
That noise. Frightened her?
What was it?
Sounded like a shot. Somewhere across the valley.
No! No, it was over here!
It's all right, love. It is gone now.
I've seen the road.
Hey? What did she say?
Like a lightning flash, I've seen it. There were no trees, just a big wide road. And things moving. Then you see it. Nobody.
Cole?
A touch of dyspepsia. I must have eaten too quickly. Rather distressful.
Did you see it, sir?
I heard a curious sound.
That might have been the echo of a fowling piece. A poacher somewhere.
It was real. It was real to me, old Sam.
And nothing else?
Greed. A clear example of vice. It's been so painful.
He's lying.
Were you?
Jethro?
Well, were you?
I will not have you speak so!
Here in this place I can. I'm not real to you, am I? I am something you made, not a man, but the man is speaking to you now, Mr. Cobb. You have a great mind, but there are too many things you won't admit.
Odd.
Hid away things, mean things, even in yourself. Yes, listen to me. They'll rise up and spoil your grand design. You can't talk them away and make a new world just with words.
Even your words, Mr. Cobb. There! It's Jeff behind that tree!
How's that for a spook? You should have seen your faces.
Now get back to the village and stay there. If I see you here again, you'll get this through your middle.
What was it?
Jeff. I frightened him off home.
Oh, I thought you'd killed...
Why should he do that, sir?
Because he's a simpleton.
Did he cause the other?
No.
Do you still think it was a shot?
She was frightened!
Reload this.
You seen it, like I did.
How much longer are we to share this midnight party for the yokels?
Have you noticed the air temperature? It's dropped.
Yes.
normal at this time of night, surely? Out here in the open?
It's not normal.
Sir, are you bent on spreading alarm? Not only to the women.
The barometer's down too. All in the past 5 minutes.
You have these simple men in terror. I appeal to you, Squire, not to submit to superstition.
Quiet.
I don't think you have the smallest idea what you're doing.
I'm setting down facts, even if I don't know what I'm doing. I make these readings for all the wrong reasons. There's no doubt about them. If I don't find out their meaning, someone else will. They'll take this notebook, as I've taken other men's, and read it and use it. It will be there to use.
That humility again. Selfless, aimless, mindless. Why do I suddenly find danger in it? Yes. Danger. Danger. Make sure you despise him for the right reasons. He's ruthless. In his way.
Timothy?
One of the blind mad pack. They will do things.
What do you mean?
Let us leave this place.
Oh, no.
Why not? I'm afraid now. You know that.
Yes.
And you want to watch it.
Was that like the sounds you heard?
I think so.
This is where we must take a grip on our senses. Whatever this be, it is of the world we inhabit. We can understand this if we seek profoundly natural.
Far away yonder. That's where it started before.
Quiet, lad.
Get a baby!
Can you manage?
I can manage another! Down there! back there. Where's the police? Get out of the way! Get back! Back up there! Find the truck! Come on, that'll shift them! Oh, it's a pile up, can't you see? It's hopeless! We're all shunted up! Dozens of them!
What did you see? Who were they? You did see? Tell me! Tell me! I must know!
She's dead. I felt her heart burst.
Dead?
She saw too. Master.
Yet someday, men will come here and make a great road through these very woods.